greet you as we gather here in St John's today, and remember Dennis, and support Caroline and Sheila, and all each other really, support one another, missing this man. Some words of scripture at the start of our service. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. It's appropriate that we gather here today in the parish church of the village that really has been the home and the heart of Dennis and Sheila's life and Caroline's growing up, and to remember him here. But these are strange times, and we would have met with many, many more people. So many would have filled this building to see Dennis off. And it's a sadness, but it's the way it is, that we can't do it in quite that way. Likewise, we're unable to gather, to be together, and to support one another, and to just have a cup of tea together at the end. And I know that is a real pain to Sheila and to Caroline, that they can't do that. But you'll understand, and we're connected here in mind and spirit with many others who aren't here, but you can think of, who connect with this moment. And thankfully, they will be able to connect with it by the streaming service or watch it afterwards. And so we send them our greetings and recognise that they are tied in to this moment of remembering, of thanksgiving, and of sorrow. So we do indeed meet in strange times and with those other people in mind. But we meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy and love be with you. We've come here today to remember before God Dennis, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, his Maker, and ultimately to commit his body to be cremated and to comfort one another in our grief. So let us pray. Almighty God, you judge us with infinite mercy and justice and love everything and everybody you have made. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven, through our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Another sadness and a loss to us is that we can't sing. Not yet. I'm so looking forward to the day when we will be able to sing together in congregations and choirs, indoors or outdoors. But what we can do is read the words, and we can listen to the music. We could even have a little quiet hum to ourselves. But let's hear and have in our hearts the sentiments and the thoughts of this lovely hymn, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. should have said at the start and forgot to say and offer sincere apologies for the fact that our heating's not working today. We had a major power cut in Tideswell yesterday, and I'm afraid it's thrown our heating out completely for all its technical wizardry, so I do apologise. We're remembering Dennis, and we are bringing together thoughts and memories, some of them spoken first by me and then by Caroline, but also in your thoughts, your memories, your hearts. So just like a beautiful floral tribute here on Dennis's coffin, so we're all bringing something to this moment. So may these words that we share stimulate your thoughts and thanksgivings and celebrations. We remember that Dennis was born and raised here in Tideswell, the only child of John Thomas Allsop, still remembered as Tideswell's taxi driver, and his wife, Hannah Alice. There wasn't much money around, but there was plenty of love. He left school, no great shakes at writing, but very good at maths. So he and Sheila made a good team later on. Dennis's first job was at Ethel's garage here in Tideswell. And it was in this period of his life which he learned his trade while he was on national service, doing mechanical engineering on Sherpa tanks. He went on to do various jobs in car and tractor sales and was working for John I. Ferns when he met Sheila at a dance at Bradwell. They married in 1960 at Haversedge Methodist Church. He went on to set up his own car sales business under the railway arches at Buxton. An initial 6-month startup became a 17-year business. Customers could always be sure of a brew, and Dennis was nicknamed Teapot. Sheila and Dennis's daughter Caroline was born in 1964. Their 35-year-long working life in Tideswell had two well-known and much-loved outlets, much-valued. They ran the laundrette for 35 years, while Dennis was much in demand as an MOT tester of motorbikes based at Turner's Garage. Classic cars and bikes continued to be a big part of his life. You'll have noticed the Triumph hearse. Appropriate, said Caroline, for a petrol head. There were no holidays at that part of their life, apparently, but Dennis loved home, and he also loved his work, so that he never felt that he was going to work. He was a natural entrepreneur, full of money-spinning ideas, like the hens kept up at the anchor. So he earned another nickname, Del Boy. But with Dennis, everything had to be straight and above board. He could talk for England and was well known for his one-liners, such as, I'm a millionaire if you don't count money. He also took a mischievous delight in stirring people up, playing devil's advocate and getting a debate going, very tongue-in-cheek, though people didn't always realise that. He was, in fact, even-tempered and easy-going. He only really insisted on not being disturbed during the 10 o'clock news and during Formula One Grand Prix screenings, when you were only allowed to breathe. Dennis and Sheila had their home, Damrose Hay, built, completed in 1974. It was the best place with the best view as far as Dennis was concerned. He said from the start that he'd have to be carried out of it in a box. In spite of encroaching illness, over about 80 years latterly, Dennis had his wish. Sheila and Caroline were helped to achieve this by the Valley Carers, always giving above and beyond the call of duty. Sheila and Caroline hesitate to pick anyone out, but Maisie and Harry's help on the day Dennis died was as impressive as it was indispensable. Also, all the doctors and staff at Tideswell Surgery, their caring has been second to none. Dennis and Sheila welcomed Dean warmly into their family when he married Caroline. Natalie came along, and her grandparents have always been involved in her life. Dennis idolised her. Dennis retired at the age of 71. Now, 14 years later, he's on his last journey in style. Sheila and Caroline want to celebrate a good life, a lovely marriage, and are thankful for a peaceful end at the last. I'm going to ask Caroline to take a deep breath and come up and share her reminiscences.
Come on, Dad, let me do this. Well, Dad, what can I say about the man I had the honour and privilege to call Dad? I just hope I do you proud, Dad, but if for any reason I start to fail, Simon has agreed to take over from me, but I wouldn't be your daughter if I couldn't open my mouth and talk, would I? I was born 50 plus years ago, the only child of Dennis and Sheila Allsop. We lived in a little two up and two down cottage in Buxton Road. Although it was a small cottage, it was filled to the rafters with love from Mum and Dad. One of my first childhood memories was of Dad taking all the children down Buxton Road to school in his car. In those days, health and safety hadn't been invented, so as many as 8 to 10 children were put into one car, and there was no seat belts, only one journey made, whether it was a mini or an estate car. It is testimony to Dad how good his driving was, as the children came every school day for the whole time I attended both Tideswell Infant and Junior School. Holidays abroad were not the thing in our house. Dad bought a touring caravan, and the only car he kept was a Volvo to tow the caravan, registration number 70YNU. As he said, Volvos were the safest car on the road. We had many holidays down Devon and Cornwall, not just 1 or 2 weeks, but due to Dad working for himself, we went to 4 to 5 weeks in the summer holidays. We were posh as well, as we had a portable TV in our caravan that Dad ran off a car battery. In the late 70s, Mum and Dad bought a field up Alma Road off the Oddfellow Society, and the building of Damarose began. Again, it was all hands on, and Dad thought nothing of me being high up on the roof, helping him with the roof trusses. I often wondered why it was me on top of the roof and not Dad. Then I realised Dad was terrified of heights. He always thought he was high up, stood on a chair changing a light bulb. Damarose is where I feel Dad was happiest, at home. He was never one for gadding about. He was happiest at home with Mum. For the past 8 years, it has been a real struggle for Dad health-wise. He went from a man who ailed absolutely nothing to a man who endured the cruel illnesses of Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. But Dad, me and Mum did you proud by keeping you in the home you loved and built, when you used to say, I built this house and I'm going out of it in a box. Although without the care of the and love of the ladies and gentlemen from Valley Care, I know this wouldn't have been possible. So from the bottom of my heart, I thank you. It is quite obvious from the turnout today, even if the weather's horrendous, Dad, that he was a petrol head. He was never happier than talking to people when they brought their motorbikes for MOT. In fact, one person did it perfectly on the announcement of Dad's passing on Facebook and Tideswell people. Having bike MOT'd 10 minutes. Time talking to Dennis, 2 hours. He also told me if I ever brought home a boyfriend who was a biker, he would be shown the door.
I wonder if it was because he knew how mad he was on a bike. I remember once being on a bike on the back of Dad. He was going well over 100 miles an hour, and all I could hear Dad say was, "Don't tell your mum." Dad also had a love for classic cars as well as motorbikes. He had a three-wheeler Morgan and a Morgan in British Racing Green, which was my favourite. And he bought a totally rebuilt a Daimler Dart. This renovation included Dad buying an industrial sewing machine and reupholstering the Dart with a lot of free advice from the machinists of Wild Country. Dad had many harebrained ideas over the years, but everything he did was always above board and honest, sometimes too honestly. Mum says he was once selling a car to a man, and Dad was telling him about the car. In the end, the man said to Dad, "Do you want to sell this car, as you're telling me everything that's wrong with it?" In the early 80s, when I left college, I got a job in Sark, in the Channel Islands, with my friend Amanda. Dad and Mum supported me all the way, making sure I knew if I got there and didn't like it, I only had to phone them and they would make sure I was on the next plane home. Well, I did come home, but not till the end of the season, and I brought Dean back with me. Dean lived near Wetherby. At first, Dad thought nothing of taking me to Sheffield Station every Friday and collecting me every Sunday so I could go and see Dean, or picking Dean up from the station if it was his turn to come to us. I'm sorry, I'm rambling on a bit, but that's how it is. After a few months, Dad even gave Dean a car so he could get to work at York. Natalie, the granddaughter, he idolised as much as she did him, has wrote a few memories she has of her granddad, so here goes. "My granddad was the best granddad in the world. He used to come and fetch me from York to stay with him and Granny in the school holidays. When we got to Tideswell, Granny had made us boiling eggs for tea. Granddad used to make cheese on toast for breakfast. Just before I went back to school, Granddad always took me to W.H. Smith, no discount stationery shops for my stationery, and he used to say, 'Get whatever you want, sweetheart, put it in the basket.' He loved eating chocolate and biscuits and drinking mugs of tea. He used to take me and Charlie the Westie walks round the lane and we sang, 'Hi ho, hi ho, it's round the lane we go, with a shovel and a pick and a rhubarb stick, hi ho, hi ho.' He would take me and Granny for lunch at Chatsworth. One day we went to Chatsworth to fly a kite. We did, and the kite came down and hit Grandad on the head. He would take me for rides in his Daimler Dart, but I wasn't keen on his motorbikes. They made too much noise. Night, night, Grandad. See you in the morning when you're snoring." As you can all tell, Dad was a much loved and respected man who lived a long and happy life in the village he was born in, Tideswell, in the home he built with Mum and a lot of help from my late Uncle Brian, and we were lucky enough to have him at home right to the end. Dad lived for four things in life: Mum, his family, food and talking. The last week of his life was horrendous and cruel to him, as Parkinson's and dementia robbed him of the ability to talk and swallow without choking. But his passing was so peaceful. I know he's at rest now. There are lots of people I need to thank, and I apologise if I've left you out. Racing Car John, a true friend to Dad, who stood by Dad right to the end. Pam and Brian, just quietly helping Mum and being there when needed. No fuss, just true friends. Tidal Surgery, especially Dr. Love, whose care for Mum and Dad is and was excellent, totally and above and beyond. Dr. Love was actually on holiday when she came, when Dad had passed. That tells you what a good doctor she is. Valley Carers, whose care for Mum as well as Dad made it possible for us to keep Dad at home, which is what he wanted. Dean, for letting me just drop everything in York to come most weekends to look after Mum and Dad, for being my rock and supporting me in all my decisions about Dad, and most of all, for doing all the little DIY jobs around Mum and Dad's house. But most of all, the thank you is from Dad for keeping him in buns right till the end and he couldn't swallow. Nearly there. And most of all, my mum. who's dedicated over 60 years of her life looking after Dad in a happy and loving family. I know the past 8 years have been horrendous for you and have certainly taken its toll on your health. But thank you, Mum, for enabling me to keep my promise to Dad, not putting him in a home. Dad was well known for his one-liners, especially to the carers. Scratch me back. We haven't got much, but we do see life. I'm struggling. You don't miss the water till the well runs dry. Well, Dad, I love you. See you later, alligator. In a while, crocodile. I'm now going to read a poem that means a lot to Mum and Dad and me as well. It's called Look For Me In Rainbows. Time for me to go now, I won't say goodbye. Look for me in rainbows, way up in the sky. In the morning sunrise, when all the world is new, just look for me and love me, as you know I loved you. Time for me to leave now, I won't say goodbye. Just look for me in rainbows, high up in the sky. In the evening sunset, when all the world is through, just look for me and love me, and I'll be close to you. It won't be forever, the day will come and then my loving arms will hold you when we meet again. Time for us to part now, we won't say goodbye. Look for me in rainbows shining in the sky. Every waking moment and your whole life through, just look for me and love me as you know I loved you. Just wish me to be near you and I'll be there with you.
Thank you, Caroline. Just invite us all really now to spend a moment in quiet reflection with those things we've heard and the things that are on our own hearts and in our own memories. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead, and strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Reading from the Gospel according to St. John, from chapter 14. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? He said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. I'm going now to prepare a place for you, Jesus says. And in my Father's house, there are many rooms. It's a picture of home. It's a picture of homecoming at the end of a long journey. Sometimes that journey can be very wearying and very hard. It can also be full of delight and joy and human companionship and love. And in fact, life for most of us is all of those things, all mixed. Perhaps deep down, all of us are looking for the journey home. We have clues about it. We've been blessed with a happy home, as you have as a family. We know something of what home's about. Dennis and Sheila had the great good fortune to be able to build their home from scratch, to enjoy living in it. So you know what it's like to prepare a place to live in, a place of hospitality and welcome, a place where people feel loved. They know they can go there. God knows that too. Jesus is telling us that a place is prepared with many rooms and a great welcome. And it's at the end of that journey, the ultimate journey, he says, where we simply have to follow in his way. Just go the way that he shows. And find the way to that door. And be welcomed in that place. So, it's to this Jesus who himself knew where he came from, the heart of his heavenly Father, where his journey was leading him, back to that heart of love. It's into those loving hands and into that way that we're entrusting Dennis today, with all our love and all our prayers. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. God of mercy, Lord of life, you've made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Dennis, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, and for those memories we're treasuring today. You promised life to those who believe. Remember for good this your child, Dennis, as we also remember him, and bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look with mercy on Sheila and Caroline, on Dean and Natalie, and all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness, and strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. And God grant us into that gate to enter, and in that house to dwell, where there shall be no cloud nor sun, no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light. No noise nor silence, but one equal music. No hopes nor fears, but one equal possession. No foes nor friends, but one equal communion and identity. No ends nor beginnings, but one equal eternity. In God's habitation, forever. I invite you, if you will, to join me in saying the Lord's Prayer quietly. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We now hear our second hymn, after we played with great gusto, because this is a lovely hymn of praise. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hand has made. As we come towards the end of our service, just to note that we'll be following the Triumph bike hearse over to Chesterfield Crematorium. And I think you'll probably know already if you're going to be joining on that cortege and be there with us. Just to note, in case you hadn't seen, that any donations you wish to make in memory of Dennis will go to Tideswell Surgery and to Tideswell Community First Responders. And there is a box for those donations at the back of church, or you can send them straight to Percival's funeral directors. We'll complete our service here with the words of commendation of entrusting Dennis to God's loving care, and some words of blessing before we move out. Could I just ask you now to take great care with your social distancing between households when you leave, once the close family have gone out, generally it's best to clear the church from the back and to keep your distance in that way as you go. We recommend that you sanitise your hands again as you leave. These things we try to do and try to do well. Would you stand with me, please, for the prayer of commendation? Let us commend Dennis to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. All these things we have remembered, and more, Dennis has given us. Thanks be to God for all that we received through him. Thanks be to God for a life well lived. And now we commend Dennis to the mercy and love of God, our Maker and Redeemer, by whose power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Dennis to God's love and mercy. In the name of Jesus, our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and always. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of his face upon you and give you peace. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Thank you.
that point.